Hi folks, Rich Pacini from RJPacini.com. Coming to you today just to make a little, I just wanted to give you a little update on something. Well, the name of this video is going to be eBay on my side. That's how I'm going to title this, this video. I just wanted to go over something with you guys real quick. I printed out a couple things here in regards to about the eBay, how they're, you know, on this particular case, they were on my side. What happened was, I was selling an Epson printer, the Epson WF2660 Workforce Wireless Inkjet Printer. So, a while back, I get a message from the buyer saying over here, let me just go back to where it starts here. Okay, review the case. I don't want to talk about that just yet. Okay. All right. The buyer has returned the thing, says the printer does not print correctly. Now, mind you, this printer was purchased back on March 7th. Okay. The buyer tells me, I want to return it. This one, I think, is a March something. March 7th it was purchased, and then I think on March 15th or the 13th they want to return it. So I said, okay. I said, no problem. Let's initiate the return process. So I clicked on there. You know, when it tells you to accept the return, and eBay has this little prompt there that says there, you'll refund the buyer upon receiving the item. Now, I was going back and forth with the buyer, telling him, did you try this? Did you try that? Did you do a line to print heads? Did you make sure it was, did you do a clean print cartridges? Because they said it wasn't printing right. I know that's a lot of malarkey, because when I had it here, I tested it out and it worked perfect. Okay. I don't know. I could be wrong. But I thought I heard, if I'm wrong, then please correct me, but I thought I heard a situation one time where a buyer opened up a return case, right, that they want to return the item. And because I think eBay has it where if a buyer opens up a case, you could refund them the money without getting the item back. And sometimes, you know, there are a lot of people out there, and I'm not saying all buyers, but it goes for both buyers and sellers. I mean, the sellers ain't no angels either in all of this. But sometimes people try to get over. Now, if I was the type of person to sit there and say, okay, the printer doesn't work, I'll refund you money. You know, in other words, hoping that they're going to return that item to me, and then, you know, I don't do that. Okay, I know. I think eBay has something in there, if I'm not mistaken. I think they have something that you could refund the buyer now and wait to get the item. So I think there is something like that. I don't work that way. Okay, I don't do things like that. You want a refund, and then I also hear stories that people say, well, I just tell the buyer to keep it. I'm not doing that. That's totally ludicrous. I am not going to let a buyer keep an item that I had to pay personally for. And I think, I'm not mistaken, well, maybe not that particular one, but I got printers now on there. I have a Brother printer that I purchased, brand new cartridges, and you could see the video yourself. I show you the video. I got the package there. I'm cutting out the package, and I'm inserting the new cartridges in there, and so on and so forth. I am not going to invest money into a printer, okay, and then have the buyer tell me, oh, it doesn't work, and they think, because that, you know, it doesn't work, they're going to send it back, that I'm going to refund them their money right over without the item. That's not going to happen. Not with me in any way. I've been hearing stories like that, though. Even in my eBay top-rated sellers group, I hear people, I just let the buyer keep it. If you could afford to do that, that's all fine and Jim Dandy. I can't afford to do that, okay? If I would have let the buyer keep the printer, and I had an incident like this once before, where the buyer said, I want to return the item, right? And, they didn't, they never, you know, if they would have returned it, if I would have said to them, okay, well, you know what, keep it. If it doesn't work, keep it, you know. I don't do things like that, because I wanted it returned back, and the buyer sent it back to me. I tested it out, and actually, I sold it for more money, to be honest with you. So I don't know what it was sold for, maybe $50, $60, $70, whatever it was. But if, could you imagine if I would have let the buyer keep it, say, well, okay, if it doesn't work, you keep it. Okay. I'm out right now $60, $70. Okay. And the buyer would get in that particular case, brand new cartridges that go with it. So I don't do things like that, folks. If you guys had experience like that, you say in some cases I'll do it, that's fine. I had one buyer buy a Guitar Hero thing. They had it for a while, and it says it right there. What happened was the buyer thought it was supposed to come with a dongle. I guess these things sync up the guitars to play with the PlayStation. And the buyer stated to me, oh, I ordered this guitar, but the dongle didn't come with it. And I emailed the buyer back saying, no, it does not come with a dongle. Okay, it does. I never sold any guitars as a package, but not that I recall. I've sold quite a few of those, but I don't recall selling it with the dongle. If I did, I don't recall. That particular one that I sold the buyer did not, with the dongle was not included with that particular guitar. And I went all through the trouble. You know, the person says, well, is there a way to sync it up? Do you know how to do this, anything? So I don't own a PlayStation. I know they work. It's been tested and stuff like that, but I don't own it. I don't own a PlayStation. So I went through the trouble to research on eBay, actually not eBay, YouTube, and how to sync up these guitars. I sent the link to the buyer, and the buyer comes back later on. After all that trouble going through, you know, because I'm looking through it and stuff like that, because it didn't come up right away. I had to make sure I got the right one for that particular guitar. The buyer doesn't say anything. Oh, it doesn't work. I want to send it back. Okay, I need an address. Send it back. I said, okay, fine. Didn't even say thank you for going out of your way to send me that video clip on how to sync the guitar, because they're asking me, do you know how to sync it up? So I said, I'll send the buyer a video. They could watch the video, and it's pretty self-explanatory, and you could do it that way. Never got a thank you, never said, oh, thanks, I appreciate it, whatever. It's okay, I don't care. It doesn't bother me. So then, on top of it, the buyer says, yeah, it's kind of pricey. Can I get the shipping to return, you know, refunded? I wrote back. I said, no, absolutely not. I can't return the shipping. No, you got to pay for that there. You bought it with those intentions. You should have read the description. It doesn't come with the dongle on it. That was a key thing there. You should have clicked off your head. Hey, the guy's selling the guitar. Doesn't have a dongle. I don't want to buy it. Okay, you buy it. You take it home. You're holding onto it for a couple of weeks. And then you decide, I want to return it. This is the only thing. This is the only problem I have with buyers. And again, I'm not trying to be mean. But what I don't understand is, with buyers, is why is it when you're getting an electronic, especially an electronic item, why don't you get it? I know I do the videos on them too to show you that it works. But if it's working here, maybe it might not work in US. I don't know. I couldn't tell you. All I know is when I test it here, if it works, it leaves the premises, it works. That's the way it is. What I don't understand is why do the buyers wait weeks? And then they say, oh, it doesn't. What did you do when you received the item? What did you do when you received it? I mean, when you got it delivered, I use priority mail when it comes to things of that nature. You're usually getting it within 3 days. Why would it take you 2-3 weeks? To get back and say, oh, by the way, it doesn't work. What were you doing with that item for that lengthy time? What were you doing with it? Were you looking at it, or did you put it on the side to wait till you had a day off from work or something like that? I mean, even if you're that busy at work, what's it going to take? 15 minutes to come home and hey, let me just test this out, see if it works, you know? And I don't understand that. I had one buyer, excuse me. I had one buyer buys a printer, waits past the 30 days, mind you, past the 30 days return. That's why I offer 30 days return policy, right? The person goes, the buyer goes, I can't get the printer to work. Is it too late to return it? Excuse me, you're past the 30 days. Okay, now I know that printer worked. I tested it out. What I think happens is, and I hear this on eBay radio, I don't want to mention names, excuse me. One of the radio announcers, whatever, or host, states, don't be too descriptive. I'm not mentioning names, okay? I'm not mentioning any names because I like the host who sponsored a radio show, eBay Radio. I like them. I like both of them. I'm not mentioning names. But my thing is, when a person says, don't be too descriptive, you know, a buyer's not going to sit there and read all this stuff verbatim, blah, blah, blah. What are you supposed to do, though? Why, if that's the case, why does eBay put in there those little things there where you could add the information? You know, like it gets like a full description. I think you guys know what I'm talking about. When you go and sign into eBay, you do your browser categories, and they have this list that pops up if it's a particular item that's in there, implemented in their system. Let's say I'm selling the Epson printer, and they have a thing where you click it on, and you get a whole description of it. It might be cryptic, but they tell you a lot about the item. Now, are you basing the description based on that? Because if that's just going to tell you the functionality of it. It's going to tell you what system it works on, this, that, and the other thing. How about the condition of it? You still have to add to your description. You know, damned if you don't. Now, if you don't add to the description and you use just what eBay gives you, that format, the buyer, and you say, oh, they got enough information. We'll do it like that. What about the description? Is it cracked, dented? Is it scratched? Is there parts missing from it? You know, is there old cartridges in it? Is there new stuff in there? If I'm selling a print that has no cartridge, I'll tell them use cartridges. You got to most likely buy new used cartridges. You know, new cartridges. Because they may be dried out. I don't know much ink is in them. You know, I don't have a leveling thing here that checks out ink. So the thing is, you know, when people say don't be too descriptive, oh, buyers don't want to read all that information. They got no time for that there. You're going to draw the buyers away. Well, then if the buyers get drawn away from it, then what can I tell you? Okay. I like to be descriptive as possible. That's why maybe people say, you know, maybe the buyer, when they go to my sites, you know, on eBay, when I put the videos in there, they might think, well, I don't need to read the description. It's all in the video. The guy's saying, that's true, but suppose there's something I left out of the video. You know, I got to put it in there. I got to have description, you know what I'm saying? And the thing is, by being descriptive like that, you're protecting yourself with eBay. Okay, because you didn't put it in there. You didn't say it was this was broken or this is missing. You didn't state it in there. You know what's going to happen, right? They're going to favor the buyer. But anyway, this video is being made because eBay was on my side. And, you know, I had a number that it's quite a few pages. I had to print this out for myself, too. eBay sends me an email, and it says, from eBay, okay, has Epson, this is how they wrote it, okay, has Epson Workforce 26 wireless springjet printer been returned? Question mark. See, from eBay, April 7th. Okay. So they say over here, I'm not going to mention the buyer's name. It says, hi, RJ Pacini, blah, 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 indicated that they shipped the return. Indicated they shipped it. Mind you, they said they indicated they shipped it. I went in there for the view of the payment, you know, details. Item was processed. In other words, I initiated the return. No transaction date as far as when it was shipped out. There's no ship date. Okay? Buyer indicated they shipped the return. Where is it? I didn't get it. Now, I gave my address. I said over here, when a refund is complete, you will automatically receive credit for the final value fees and other applicable fees. Okay. Then it says, to see more information, you can go to, and then you go to the return details. Okay. Then it says, issue a refund. If the item hasn't arrived, the buyer may not be returning it. Well, I would think so. I would think that. If you like, you can contact the buyer, or if you can't reach a resolution, you could ask us to step in. What do you think I did? eBay, step in, please. Okay. I sent eBay a message. Okay. Well, eBay said sent the message to whatever. Why am I receiving this email? You're receiving this email based on your account preferences. If you'd rather not receive these emails, okay, unsubscribe. Okay, that's okay. So then I went over here. I opened up, this is another page thing here. It says over here, this is really quick too. I mean, that's why I said eBay was on my side with this here. I told eBay that I haven't received the item. And I don't want to issue a refund until I actually get the printer back. So that's where I stand right now. I never received it. So eBay sends me this thing here within a matter of minutes. They said, we'll get back to you. I said, I told them the information. I said, I want you to check into it, blah, blah, blah. Within a matter of minutes, no exaggeration. Hi, Richard. We reviewed the case and have closed it out without any refund to the buyer. The case will not affect your seller performance. Any feedback left for this transaction will be removed. The buyer did not return the item to you within the required time frame. This is the first. Okay, I had a couple returns. But a lot of those returns were my fault. And the reason why I say that there is because the buyers didn't read the item before they purchased it. And I stayed at the eBay. That's why if you look, it shouldn't have any returns. If there are returns, eBay's got to take care of that, take them off. Because I explained to them many a times or a couple times over, the buyer buys things and they don't read the description like they should. It makes the seller look bad. Okay. Now, I'm trying to keep a good reputation on eBay. And also, if a buyer has a discrepancy with the item they purchased from me, don't leave a negative feedback. Don't leave any feedback. I don't really care one way or the other, but don't leave a negative one. Contact me. Okay, if you don't want to, if we could resolve it together, that's fine. But if you don't want to leave a feedback, that's fine too. If you're not happy with my service, don't leave a feedback. Okay, but don't leave a negative one either. You know, just leave it blank. Don't bother with it. Okay, but anyway, so eBay has that thing there where they work with me in this one here, and then they say over here, they have it over here when you're returning it. They say over here see case details. So when you click the see case details, you come up with this sheet here. What you need to know before you proceed. This sheet comes up. Okay. And it says over here, when a case is open, you should respond to it and try to work things out with your buyer. Provide the best services that you can because 4 days after the case is open, the buyer can escalate the case to eBay customer support for a decision. If you issue a full refund, your final value fees will be credited back to you. If you can't work things out, the case may be escalated to eBay. We will review the case and make a final decision. In this decision, if the decision is made in the buyer's favor, which 9 out of 10 it usually is, we will refund the buyer. eBay will refund the buyer and seek reimbursement from you. Okay, you may be asked to set up a reimbursement payment method. And it says learn more. Then it says continue to use case. But I love this last one. This one right here. I don't want to hold up too long because I'm not here to shame the buyer. But it says over here, eBay customer support has made the final decision. The buyer did not return the item within the required time frame. The case, blah, blah, blah. It's just what I said earlier. This case was found in your favor. Final decision. I almost jumped out of my socks when I got this. You might say, well, if you're on the right, why would you feel that way? Why? Because the last time a buyer did that, they sent the printer back, and I think I did a video on it or talked about it. The faceplate was popped out. They threw it in a box. The bubble wrapping wasn't even wrapped around the printer. They took the printer and threw it in a box, threw bubble wrap all over it, and that was it. When I got that package, I was shaking. That thing was rocking and rolling. It was having a party in there, okay? And when I opened up, I said, this is not going to be good. And sure enough, I opened it up. I seen the faceplate popped out. Thank God it wasn't damaged, cracked. I was able to reinsert it, test out the printer, make sure everything was tested on it, and that I resold it again for the same price. Okay? But in this particular issue, eBay was on my side. And I got the paper right here to prove it to myself. Not to you guys, but to myself. You know, I want to keep this record for myself. And, I told them. You know, they said, did you get the thing back? And I told eBay when I said, why do you want to escalate? I said, the buyer did not send the printer back, and I don't want them to refund. I don't want a refund until I get it back. So here's the thing. The buyer gets it. They purchase it March 7th. They say that the thing was being or sent back by March 15th. So, I don't know, you're talking a little over a week and a half, almost 2 weeks. And I'm over here checking the P.O. box, like to see maybe they sent it to the P.O. box. Maybe something got messed up over there. And I gave them my home address, which I really don't like to do, to send the item back. You know, wait for the postman to come by and see if he's going to pull up, because they usually pull up first. They have big packages, and they'll give it to you right there and then. One day went by, another day went by, 1 week went by, another week went by. So from March 7th, when it was purchased, this is why, well, let me put it this way too. The reason why eBay also found this to be in my situation, my case, is because it passed the 30-day, it was on the 30-day thing too. So let's, I mean, I want to give eBay credit for that. Don't get me wrong. They were on my side, but you got to understand, it's from March 7th to April 7th. So of course they're going to, eBay's got to do the right thing by me. They got to, eBay is on my side in that case because they, you know, not saying they violated the return policy, that the buyer did, but, well, in that case, I guess they did because, you know, it wasn't sent back then. They should have sent it way back to get their money back. So, in the meantime, I'm over here driving myself batty thinking, oh, okay, because it was a decent amount of money to return. But I would return them. I mean, I refund them. You know, they got to pay for return shipping. That's how it is. And the last time, though, and this is the thing that irked me about eBay, is when I took pictures of that printer that came back and showing you the faceplate was off and it was a little how it was packaged up, eBay didn't give me a nanosecond to get back to the person selling them, you know, to tell them, you know, what it was. I took pictures of it and I showed them how it was packaged. They made that final decision lock, stock, and barrel. I went through eBay. I told them, I said, look how I got the package back. Our decision's made up. We're very sorry you feel this way, blah, blah, blah. We issued a full refund. They got, not only did they get their full, they got the full refund back with the printer and the shipping. You know, that's what I'm saying. And I said to myself, what am I supposed to do with this printer? Thank God I was able to fix it. But the thing is, you know, the thing is, folks, what really irks me with some of the buyers, and I know they're not all bad, not all buyers are bad, and I'm not speaking bad against buyers. Like, sellers are no better either, like I said once before. Sellers are no better. I mean, I heard stories too. If you look on YouTube, you could see stories from scammers and all this. They got all these YouTube things about how to sell as a selling things or whatever, and they're things like junk. They get them and they're like not even fully descripted, even stuff like that. So, you know, the sellers ain't no better in this case too. But what I don't understand though is with the buyers, and this happened a couple of times too. I had another situation. I was selling Apple earbuds. For a decent price, it wasn't expensive. And I put in the description, stuff like that. I get it, I think maybe about a week later or a week and a half later. I already have a pair of these, I need to send them back. Wait a minute. Why did you order them for? You know, what did you order them for? Why would you, do you need an extra? I can understand people might want an extra pair. All right, I'll be honest with you. For my car, I have, for my phone, my cell phone, because I don't always carry the adapter one like that. I have a USB. I bought a separate USB cable I keep in my glove box, you know, to charge my phone, because I don't want to carry the one for the house. I don't want to take it, put it in and out of the car, in the house, and so on. So I bought a little USB cable that plugs into my cigarette light, you know, into my dash, and, you know, I connect my phone to it, my cell phone. But I bought that purposely so I could have one for the car and one for the home. Now, some people, maybe the lady did that purse, whoever it was, bought that earbuds and, you know, maybe they had an extra set laying around, maybe they didn't, I don't know. It was cheap enough, I didn't charge an arm and a leg for it. But then he said, all right, we're going to send it back. I go, okay, send it back, here's where you send it back. It's small enough, I said, send it to my P.O. box. And I'm waiting, because I go there once a week. I don't always go there because 9 out of 10, the only time I'll go there is if somebody's going to return stuff. I go there once a week to check out some of the mail I have, because I don't like to have the mail coming to my, I don't want my personal home address on at all time. Either on eBay, you know, they got to have a shipping address. I understand that, but I use the P.O. box for that purpose. Plus, I get all my mail there too, all my other advertisements. And I'm waiting. So I say, all right, let me go check. Sometimes I make an extra trip down there. I might go two times a week. You know, I go Friday. I usually go on Fridays, and I go like sometimes I might go on in the middle of the week, or maybe I just go Saturday. I won't go Friday. I just go Saturday. I went there a couple times that week when they said we're going to send it. Never got it returned. We're going to send it back. I'm sending it back. Okay, send it back. Never got it back. Yeah. So I didn't hear anything. Nobody opened the case up. But here's the thing. Here's what I wanted to get. I was getting to. I think sometimes with this particular case, so I'm not saying I can't. I'm not, like I said, I'm not mentioning buyers. I'm not making any derogative statements here. All I'm saying is I think some people are under the impression that could be wrong. And if I'm wrong, correct me. Okay. But I think sometimes when people open up these type of situations or act on these type of situations, saying, in this particular case, the printer don't work, I want to send it back. I think in their mindset, they're thinking, oh, you know what? He's the type of buyer that'll give you the refund without getting the item back. And, you know, that's it. And then we'll just say, we sent it out, but we never, you know, there's no open case. There's no formal proof that you have it, you know what I'm saying? If they don't open a case, and that's just between me and the buyer, so okay, you send it here, send it with the tracking or whatever we're gonna send it. You know, eBay doesn't have anything like that unless it goes through the eBay return policy, that way they have it set up. And I think some people think by doing that there, we'll get over. We'll get to keep it. We'll get our refund. We'll keep it, and then we'll just tell the buyer we sent it. But the seller said, well, maybe he never got. I didn't receive it. You know, how am I going to have proof? You know what I'm saying? It's just like when you send something out to a buyer. The buyer can get the item, say, I never received it. There's a lot of, look, I'm not making this stuff up. If you go to YouTube and type in people being scammed on eBay, or, you know, just try it one day and see what comes up. You'll be in an aura of disbelief with the things you hear. All right. Just to sum it up in a nutshell. There was one person I follow. I don't mention names, but people who hear the story may say, oh, I know who that person is. Person was selling a keyboard. They did a video before and after. The keyboard was perfect from the video I seen, because this person did a live video. And when the person got it back, they said, yeah, after the buyer got it, ah, oh, it doesn't work. Or this is not what I want. When that seller got that keyboard back, it was picked clean. Keys missing inside of the keyboard. There was some things missing. I don't know. Like I said, I don't know what. I'm not going to mention, because I don't want to. You know, you could just find out on your own. But I felt so bad for this seller. The person took pictures of it before and after with eBay, right? I mean, this thing, if you look at the pictures before and after, the thing was perfect. It was perfect. Okay? And when a person got it back, parts were missing, keys were missing. I mean, how could you do that to somebody? And you want to hear the funny thing? No, not funny. It's a sad thing. Do you know, after the video was shown, person contacted eBay, you know what they said? eBay said, basically, suck it up. He had to refund the buyer's full amount, shipping and handling, if I'm not mistaken, the whole kit and caboodle. Here's a person, a seller, that once was a nice, perfect keyboard. It's been stripped. It's ready for this. You can't do anything. It's garbage. I mean, you might as well throw it in the garbage. And, you know, I feel bad, because when you're buying this stuff, unless someone's giving it to you for free, or if you're driving around the neighborhood and you find, let's say, the neighbor a couple houses down is throwing one out, you say, well, I got it for free. I don't really care. But if you're buying stuff, that's when it hurts. A lot of stuff I sell, some things are donated from family members. Some things I got to pay for. Okay? And even if you say, well, how about the stuff you get from your relatives? They just give it to you. Do you still want it? Yeah, I still want it back. That's why I do this here. I mean, I think that's why all of us sellers are in this business, to make money. You know, I mean, there are people out there, like I said, if you listen to eBay Radio, or I hear a couple of sellers and even a couple of people on that show will say, well, I sometimes let the buyer keep it and I refund, and then I give them a refund. I refund their money back, their shipping. I don't do that. because I have it right stated in there when I'm setting up my description, buyer pays for return shipping. And the reason why I feel that way, people say, well, that's, you know, you could bend that. Not if you're selling something that's going to cost you $20 or $30 for shipping. Okay? I can't give the buyer his full refund and then some. In other words, like, let's say they print the cost $30 to ship it. He's going to get his full payment price plus the shipping, and then I'm out of $30. I can't do it that way. I can't. It doesn't work that way for me. And I'm not being mean or anything. I'm being upfront. You start dipping into your profits like that, profit and losses, forget about it, you know. But there are some people that go through scenarios like that. And, you know, I get a kick when I hear people that when they say, oh, you know, I give a buyer, I just refund the buyer. I just give them the full amount back. That's good. If you could afford it, I'm a small-time operator here. I can't afford to give 10 here, 15, 20, $30. I can't afford that right now. Okay, that's why I'm doing this here. You know, I mean, that's why I'm in this business. I'm trying to make a living out of it. I'm trying to make a go out of it. And if I have to keep dishing out money like that, what's the sense? You know what I'm saying? I mean, and as far as letting people keep it, when I hear stories where people say, oh, yeah, let the buyer keep it. I guess it also depends on what you're letting a person keep. But, you know, again, if I'm buying something, if I'm going to a thrift store and I'm picking up a printer that costs me X amount of money, you know, and I tell the person and I don't tag on a profit on it, that's now I'm really out of the money. You know what I'm saying? I mean, so many people say, well, you could always just sell it for what you paid for it. You know, take it like that. I don't want to do things like that. I mean, you know, if you can't make a profit of something, what's the sense of me being in this business? But anyway, I don't want to really get into that there. I just wanted to share that with you folks that this is the first time. I mean, you might say, well, this guy's complaining. It's not complaining. I'm just sharing my first experience that eBay was actually on my side. But I just want to point out one last thing. I find it kind of amusing. I don't know if eBay knows about it. It doesn't really affect me in any way, but I'm not mentioning names, folks, but now this is, if you look over here, this is off eBay's messaging, right? Now, yeah, I'll show you. Now, if you look up here really quick, so it says ebaymessage.com, right? All right. Now, look over here. You see what that says? See that? Okay. Now, I'm not mentioning names, but I found that kind to be kind of amusing when I think about it on eBay's website. Okay, people might ask me, what is that? What? Tell me who it is. You'll find out if you see it on there, you click it on, then you can tell me who it is. But I'm not saying anything. I just find it amusing. I know who it is. I know who this description is. I know who this is. And I find it amusing that it's posted on eBay's messaging thing. I just want to share that with you guys. Anyway, that's going to be the name of the video, eBay on my side. And I'm not making a big thing over, folks. I just wanted to share that with you. I escalated to other topics and stuff, but I just wanted to share that with you guys. If anybody had an experience like that with buyers, or similar to my case, let me know. You know, tell me. If you think I'm wrong about my return, the way I look at the return policy, as to, you know, refunding the buyer the money, you know, the shipping, and you know, in other words, give a full refund, and then plus, I pay the shipping out of my pocket. If you know, people think, well, that's wrong, you should do that or do the right thing, you know, look, I'll say this in closing. There was a situation where a buyer ordered something from me. I forget what it was. And I don't know if they read, I think they read the instructions and whatever, you know, the description, but it was a small enough amount to refund. And I told the person, you know, I felt bad because it wasn't my fault. What happened was the buyer bought something. I forget what it was. I don't know if it was some kind of electronic thing. I don't remember exactly. But I remember the buyer buying something. And they read the description. They knew everything was going on. But for some reason, they couldn't get it to work, that particular item to work. Now, you know, some people, maybe they wanted to check something out to see, you know, test it. And, well, let me bought off this guy. I'll test out the item, see if it works. And if not, I'll return it. It was cheap enough to do. And the person messaged me, the buyer messaged me, I tried to see her out. I can't get it to work. You know, would you be willing to, you know, take a accept a refund? You know, can I return it? I said, sure. And then in that same, you know, in the same comment, he writes back, he or she, whatever. I guess I'm going to take a loss on the return, you know, the return shipping cost. It was cheap enough, mind you. Okay, it might have been, I don't know, $3, whatever it was. I know people are saying, oh, wow, this guy is making big, he returned. I ended up eating that money, all right. But it's because the buyer read the description. I forget exactly what it was. I know it was something to do with electronics. This was a while back. I don't document everything I do. I mean, I might have it in my files, but I don't remember it 100%. I remember saying, look, don't worry about the refund, you know, the shipping cost. I'm going to refund that for you as well. You're going to get that as well. I mean, you know, I want to just say this too. You know, on my eBay Top Rated Sellers group on Facebook, I noticed a couple people are stating on there, people like on the group, they were saying that, you know, even when they refund the buyer, none of them even get a thank you. And I know that's true because I've done that myself one time. I you know, not refund, but like if you try to do the right thing, you try to interact with the buyer to see if you could work things out. They don't, 9 out of 10, the buyer won't say, like that buyer that I refunded that money to never got back to me and said, well, thank you for refunding. I appreciate you. You know, now, I'm not that, I don't want accolades and I'm not looking here for, you know, people to sit there and, you know, kowtow to me. I'm not looking at that. I mean, but it would have been nice if the buyer could say, well, thank you for, you know, also, you know, refunding me your shipping costs as well. You know, I mean, cause like I said, that's coming out of our accounts, you know, but on the group, there were a couple of people who said, oh, don't feel bad. I was reading, you know, sometimes I comment on them, sometimes I don't. I think I might have commented on that one. And the buyers don't always thank you for that. And I'm sure you guys might experience that as well. And the other thing is, with feedbacks, while it's still fresh in my mind, I've been noticing my feedbacks are going up a little, but not everybody is responding. With everything, from the time I sold to the time now, I should have had at least over 1,500 feedbacks, maybe more. So it just goes to show you how many people do not respond back to you, you know, as far as leave a feedback. And they don't have to. Even the radio talk show hosts, they say the same thing. You know, they don't have to leave a feedback if they don't want. That's fine. I'm just saying. But you know how I counteract that, folks? And it's not wrong what I'm doing. But if you experience a situation like that where you're doing your due diligence and you're selling, you know, practices, and you know that you're doing good and stuff like that. The way I handle it now is I put in there, now on their positives, and I'm not saying bad, but you know, when you for the buyer's feedback, you will put their super buyer pace promptly, whatever, so on and so forth. I've been doing stuff like that in the past, and I don't always get response back. So what I do now is I put in there, thank you for shopping at RJ Pacini, satisfaction guaranteed. When it says leave a comment, you know, leave a feedback, that's what I leave. So when the buyer gets it, I'm thanking the buyer. So you might say, but wait a minute, you're leaving a positive. You're leaving a positive on their positive. If you're not going to send me a feedback, right? If you have no intention to send me a feedback, my thing is, I'll send you a feedback, but I'm thanking you is what I'm doing. I'm not doing anything wrong. I'm not doing anything bad. I'm thanking the buyer. So there's nothing wrong with that. So it looks like saying, oh, you're still getting a positive feedback no matter how you look at it, because when people go to the buyer's feedback, they're going to see, oh, thank you. They're going to say, thank you for shopping at RJ Pacini, satisfaction guaranteed. Well, yeah, that's true. They are going to see that. Other buyers or sellers will look at that and, you know, look at that buyer's feedback, and they will see that. And I don't see anything wrong with it. Okay. If they don't want to leave me a feedback, I'm going to at least thank them. You know, when I walk out of Walmart, I make a purchase at Walmart, they say thank you for shopping at Walmart. It's the same thing. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm not doing anything wrong. I don't think that's violating any policies or anything. I'm thanking the buyer. The only difference is I'm not saying buyer pays prompt, buyer is excellent, excellent pay, you know, whatever, is excellent, A plus. The only thing I'm doing is saying thank you for shopping at RJ Piscini. Satisfaction guaranteed. That's all. I'm thanking them. I'm thanking the buyer. I don't see anything wrong with that. And if people say, well, how about the buyer? If the buyer does reply to you, suppose that buyer, after you said thank you, they reply. Let me tell you something. I've been doing that practice for quite some time. And I'm not saying for years, but recently, because I was getting tired of not getting feedbacks. And you want to know something? I'm still getting nice feedbacks back from the buyers I do, because I know I'm getting them back because I'm using the same wording, okay, and they're responding back to me, so I'm not doing anything wrong. Apparently I'm not getting any complaints. I don't hear anything from the buyer saying, you didn't leave me a positive feedback. I'm thanking you. That's a positive feedback. I'm thanking you. I'm thanking you for for shopping with me. Okay, I mean, you know, what am I supposed to do? You know, that's the way it goes, but you guys might want to think about that. You know, if you're not getting feedbacks, and again, the buyer doesn't have to leave a feedback. You know, they don't have to leave feedbacks for us. If they don't have to. I know the reason why they probably do it is because eBay has a thing. You know, I think every now and then a prompt comes up that you know, I guess something about you have an outstanding feedback or whatever. I think that's why they do it. They eventually get back to you. But yeah, I'm not doing anything wrong. By doing that practice the way I'm doing it, there's nothing wrong with it. I don't find anything wrong with it. If anybody thinks there is something wrong with it, again, leave a comment. I'm always willing to listen to what people have to say. I don't think there is. I don't think there is anything wrong with it. Okay, I'm thanking the buyer. Thank you for shopping with me. You know, you as a YouTuber, you come to my channel, you buy something, I'm thanking you. I'm giving you a heads up now. I'm thanking you for shopping with RJ Piscini. I don't think there's anything wrong with the folks. But anyway, sorry I'm rambling on, talking about this stuff here. I just wanted to share that with you. This is, like I said, this is, you know, it made, you know, when I received this information, it kind of like, you know, made me happy at some point that eBay was on my side with this here. And, you know, I just wanted to share that with you guys, you know, and just throw it out there. Anyway, thanks for stopping by. If you got any questions or comments you want to leave to me, that's fine. If you like what I do at my channel, you want to subscribe to it, I'd love to have you as a subscriber. If you like what I do with the videos, you want to give it a thumbs up, that'd be great. And that's basically it. I guess I'll talk to you guys soon. I got to do some photographs now, and I got to do some more videos, demo videos. So thanks again for stopping by, guys. You take care. Have a great day, and good selling on eBay. I wish you all the best. Bye now.